again, thank you, NorCal Sports TV, for recording this event. I'm your host, Carmelo De La Fuente, along with my colleague and color commentator, Chelsea Berry. The All-Star Game is in its fourth year and has established itself as a premier event to honor the seniors that played in the high school season. Chelsea, as someone that has played elite volleyball her entire career, what do you think is going through these girls' heads before the game?
Honestly, definitely a lot of excitement, maybe some nerves. You know, they've played all 4 years of high school, and some of them aren't going to college. So they're here to give it their all, you know, enjoy volleyball as long as they can. It seems like they're prepared. They're excited. I talked to Delaney Orr before this, and she was definitely really excited. You know, she isn't playing in college, but she loves the game of volleyball, and I know everyone here is just excited to watch, and they're ready to go. I can see.
No, the energy is great. The crowd's still coming in, and it looks like we have full stands on the other side of the court over there.
Yeah.
But also, you know, just honoring these seniors it's something that this area needed. You
oh,
know,
100%.
And in its fourth year now, this All-Star Game has done a great job growing each year into becoming something that these seniors look forward to. At the end of their seasons. I know that there are some big plans in the works, as in, you know, having an outdoor game, you know, in this area as mm-hmm. well. But the biggest thing is, you know, how can we properly send off these girls to prepare them for the future? Like you said, some of them are going to some Division I schools. Some
yeah,
are going
awesome.
To JCs.
Yep.
But at the same time, from Commitment 9 on, This All-Star Game has given them speakers to let them know that they can persevere and they can handle anything.
Right. I wish they had this when I played. This is great. I'm excited.
Looks like we're getting started.
Yep.
Both teams lined up on the service line. And we would like to thank the Denair Lumber Company for sponsoring this event for the fourth year in a row. Denair Company, let's build together. The announcer is honoring each school.
Big Valley Christian. Oh, a lot for that one.
Well, Big Valley Christian have found some success this year, reaching the state finals, unfortunately losing, I believe, in five sets.
Oh, it's a good game.
Hillmar High School getting their intros. This year, only three players. Last year, I think they had about nine. It was like a sea of green out
That's
there.
That's crazy. Love to see color this year.
Our officials for today's event will rotate from up official to down official and the lines. They'll rotate around. The officials
today... Jamie Hamilton, Melinda Freeman, Jan Shefkowitz, and Angelina Chavez. I've worked with all four, being a former official myself, and each one of them absolutely has the utmost integrity and will make the right call, you know, regardless of how long it takes. Again, four true professionals out there officiating this match.
Awesome.
Number 6, Esmeralda Arroyo. Mm-hmm. Number 1, Emma Blake.
Looks like they're introing each each of the schools right now, small schools being introed. Number 22, Bella Speicher. Number 1, Emma Blake.
Number 11, Jenna Gomes.
Looks like we have a few numbers that are being shared here. Number 5, Carissa Hoekstra. And we have the starters about to be introed. Number 3, Leighton Romero. She's got some noise.
Yeah,
some
she
support.
Does. She's a lot of fans here today.
Number 12, Sierra Thibodeau. Parents Derek and Kim. Number 6, Addie Garst. Number 13, Sophia Alamo from Hillmar.
A lot of Hillmar fans.
Yeah. Number 9, Caitlin Cole from Stone Ridge Christian. And libero number 4, Leilani Aguilera from Gustine. And Felicity Still, number 1 from Houston High School. Coaches being introduced right now.
This is Patricia Flanagan-Cordina, and the head coach of Merced High School, and the head coach, Mr. Ken Shaw.
Merced High School, Patricia, and head coach Ken Shaw. Merced High School found some success this year, beating Pittman High School for probably the first time in a very long time.
Wow, really?
And Ken Shaw, obviously a veteran coach.
Mm-hmm.
I believe he won 3 back-to-back-to-back, you know, state titles.
That's awesome.
He did a great job. And here we have the North schools being introduced. Number 11, Cora Cover from Central Catholic. Cora Grover, sorry. Number 26, Annie Pecanino. Number 6, Lydell Springer. Number 23, Bella Cormick. Number 1, Grace Ferreira from Escalon High School. And now the starting lineups. Number 5, Bella Chapin.
Bella, she's a fun player to watch.
Number 18, Addison Machado from Central Catholic. Number 3, Kate Cover from Central Catholic. Setter, amazing player.
Mm-hmm. Excited to watch her today.
Number 8, McKinley King and daughter of the director of the All-Star Game, Aaron King. Number 9, Alexis Roost from Big Valley Christian. And number 19, Amanda Murphy from Escalon High School, Offensive Player of the Year, and I believe TVL MVP for the league.
I did see that. That's great.
And then number 15, Emily Van Groningen, future Pacific Tiger from Ripon Christian, middle blocker.
Excited for her.
Number 8, Delaney Orr.
As honorable mention for the North Small School All-Star.
Coaches for the North. You have Josh Spivey.
Mm-hmm.
He told me not to say Joshua, but I'm going to say Joshua anyway. Josh Spivey and Michelle Springmeier.
Great coaches.
Looks like the coaches are going to say something here.
Some confusion. We don't know yet.
Passing the baton. And Central Catholic outside hitter Abby Castellon being honored as an honorable mention. Abby, a senior, has played high-level club volleyball. Unfortunately, has been injured her last two high school seasons, which is tough. But she's on the road to recovery. And, you know, you and I both know Abby personally. And we know that she's a fighter and is working hard on her comeback right now.
It's sweet that they did that.
And you know, that's where I think that an event like this really does stand out because, you know, a senior that has worked hard, loves volleyball,
mm-hmm.
That's exactly the person that you do want to honor here. Even though she's not on the court with her teammates, she definitely deserves a shout-out for her accomplishments.
100%. Can vouch for that. I've been there.
Yeah, being somebody that was injured yourself and having to make a comeback, right?
Yep. 3 surgeries deep. Actually, 4 now. 4 surgeries deep.
Wow.
ACL, meniscus. I know she did the same. That's sweet. I can see her a little tearing up over there. She probably wants to really be out there.
Right. mom is Amber Lugo.
Yep. Coached with her.
Fantastic coach. So you know, head coach for the Turlock High School Bulldogs. And again, just an awesome volleyball family.
Yeah, they're great. They're a great family. Beautiful voice.
Being a singer yourself, what do you give that singer for the national anthem there?
10 out of 10. That was great. You had no nerves whatsoever. That's hard to do.
You're saying that with a lot of confidence.
Yeah, that's great.
Gave me kind of chills there a little
bit. I know. I loved it. Get this game started for us today.
You know, both teams here warmed up, ready to go. You know, you have two coaches, two head coaches here with completely different coaching styles. Ken Shaw on the left at the South Schools. A great coach, great personality, loves volleyball, didn't even touch a volleyball till he was in college, ends up being, you know, state champion, section champion multiple times. Just knowing him personally, he, you know, game teaches the game. You know, he sees sports as an opportunity to grow and to even fail a little bit. And, you know, just talking to him before the game, he said his message to his girls are, go out there, have fun, compete, and let's see what happens.
That's some good, like, you know, some. It's good to, like, say to a team that, like, you know, hasn't really, like, played together. You know what I mean? These are all girls from different schools. So it's go out there and have fun. You know, it's not going to be, like, you know, I don't know how to explain it. But
right. Each small school here having three practices apiece before this game. You know, again, he's not giving his team any pressure to win.
Yeah, I love that.
You know, and this game is more about honoring the sport of volleyball and also honoring the girls on the court. Looks like we're about to get started here. Number three, Kate Cover for Central Catholic is going to be our first server. Here we go.
The North seems really excited, and they all know each other, so that's actually good.
They seem pretty confident.
Yeah.
Kate with a jump float to left back. South responding with an outside attack. That finds the floor.
A lot of looking there. Commit and go.
You know, you got a big crowd here. Maybe there's some nerves in play.
Oh, 100%. You know, as a player, I can see that.
You got the South serving number six from Hilmar. Out of system attack.
Smart idea.
Nice touch there by Mandy Murphy. Beating the middle blocker on the inside tip. Looks like we have our first substitution. McKinley King, number eight, being subbed out by...
Number one,
Grace Fiera. Standing float to middle back. We got a right side attack. Kate with the set to Emily. And Emily crushes it to the right side for a point.
That was a great spot. You know, no one was there. She saw it and she went up. She got it.
It's funny because that's the exact play that happened for Ripon Christian to win a section title.
That's awesome.
Let's see, South with an outside attack. Dig by number 18. Outside attack by Big Valley outside hitter Alexis Roost for the point. Nice tool off the block.
Yeah, she was confident on that. She's like, out. Arms up.
Grace back for a third time serving. Getting her signal from her coach. Standing float to the right side. Out of system set. Got a push. Kate with a bump set to the outside. Big swing.
That's
able
to dig.
Controlled by number 4. Right side attack by number 9. Mandy Murphy here.
I think the north side's doing a good job with placing the ball at this point. They see the holes, and they're definitely going for them.
Right. Andy Murphy playing a different position right now on the right side for the north schools. Outside attack here by the south. Little roll shot over. Kate Cover able to get the dig. Attack to left back. Controlled nicely by the south. Big swing by the outside. Block touch with the second touch. Keeping it alive. Nice control by the north. And a double touch here by the South School. You know, how many times have we seen the Kate Cover set that middle attack to Emily Van Groningen, two players that have played together for the last 4 or 5 years?
We're definitely going to see that a lot tonight.
Right. Got fifth serve here by the North Schools. Out of system pass. Not able to get good contact on that ball into the net.
Seems the South is just a little bit struggling to connect to one another.
You know, I would say if we can communicate a little bit more, maybe the South can get something going. But
yeah.
Still good energy on the court.
Yeah.
Nice in-system pass to the right side, Mandy Murphy. Able to put it away. Nice kill.
Like you said, communication. You know, they both looked. You just got to go.
And we got our first time out here. The North School is up 7-1 over the South. North showing a whole lot of control right now. Maybe not talking as much as we expected, but at the same time, just doing what they do best, which is play good volleyball.
Yeah, they're going out there, going for everything. You know, it's going to be a little rocky in the beginning, you know, getting to know who's going to go where. So looks good right now, though.
You look at the difference between the athlete that's on the court experience-wise. You have a lot of high-level volleyball players here playing for the North. On the South, you know, it's always hard to win at this level, and sometimes heart can really change the momentum for your team. With volleyball being a momentum-based sport,
oh, yeah.
Let's see if the South can get a side out here and get some points for their side. Number 1, Grace Ferreira, serving for the 6th time for the North Schools. Serve the middle back, add a bump set to the outside, double block, and smart play there by number 12, Sierra Thibodeau from Orestimba.
I was telling Carmelo when they were warming up, Southside does a really good job with hitting deep, and I think that's where the North is going to be struggling a little bit because they're not expecting it. They're thinking it's out, so that's actually good for the South.
Right. That's where you want to hit it when you're not comfortable.
Exactly.
And we got a four-touch violation here by the North Schools. South able to push a point here. Good serve by number 1. I believe that's Felicity Sill from Houston High School. Felicity with the standing float to middle back. Out of system set to the outside. Nice hustle play. Emily Van Groningen able to get a block touch there. And a push by number 12. Set to the right side, Amanda Murphy. And like she's done, I think it was about 470 times this year on Max Preps. she gets a kill off the set. And again, just like with Emily Van Groningen, setter Kate Cover knows Amanda Murphy well. Get that ball in the hittable position and she'll put it away. Got Emily Van Groningen here on the attack, the left back, able to ace.
So it seems like the South is struggling to move their feet back and forth. So as a server, you know, you want to keep moving the serve all the way around the court.
Emily back with another serve. Ooh. Middle back just a little bit long.
She was definitely testing them.
As a competitor, we know that Emily does not like making mistakes.
Nope.
And I bet she wishes she has that one back.
Yeah.
We got number four, Leilani Aguilera from Gustine, back to serve. She's playing the libero position for the south side. Oh, got some style on that serve.
Mm-hmm.
In system set here by the north. Nice hustle play by the outside for the south schools. And number nine, Alexis Roos, just not able to get that ball over. Out of system play, wasn't high and hittable, just got him in trouble.
Yeah, you saw Delaney go, my bad.
Ownership.
Yep.
Back to serve, number four.
Great nice. Up.
Great pass.
Mm-hmm.
Amanda Murphy able to get the attack. She even walked away before the ball hit the ground because she just knew that that ball was going to be a kill.
Oh, yeah.
Nice swing. But even though she got the kill, number eight, Delaney Orr for the North, I think deserves all the credit for that play.
It was great up.
Just bettering that ball. Nice job. We got number 26 from Central Catholic for the North, Annie Pecanino back to serve. She's looking for the serving spot from Coach Josh Spivey. And the South responding with the right side attack. Annie Pecanino able to get that ball alive to high middle. Kate Cover and bumps it over. And South seeing a free ball.
Ooh.
Runs a tempo play to the outside. Big block there by Kate Cover.
A lot of excitement for the North. They were really loving that block.
Well, blocking's hard to do. And
yep.
Probably the hardest thing to do in volleyball. Annie Pecanino back to serve. Maybe rush just a little bit there. Yep. Hits the top tape.
She's trying to keep that momentum going.
You know, how important is it to have a routine when you go back there to serve?
Oh, definitely important. I do the same exact thing every time. I even put a little smile before I go. It's like, I don't know.
Number five, Hannah Bibbins with the jump float to right back. Got Kate Cover with her first attack of the set. Middle attack responding by Hilmar's middle, number 13. Push over by Annie Pecanino. Set to the outside. Big swing, able to control it. North responding with the right side attack from Kate Cover. Out of system play to right back. Hits it long. And North able to score another point.
The South is doing a good job, you know, reading the hitters and getting good touches. The blockers are doing a really good job helping the back row there.
Well, after that six-point run, it's good to see the South stepping up and playing some good volleyball. Still down by six, but the energy is definitely different.
Right, yep.
North here with a serve. Hard serve to the middle back, easily controlled. Outside attack by South. Got a right side attack here. Doug, nice and high. Unfortunately, South out of system. Annie Pecanino setting the right side. Got a tip. Middle attack response by the South. Able to keep that alive off the block touch. Free ball back over. Set to the outside. Big swing. North still able to control it. Looks like we have a net violation on the attack.
That was smart on the middle to take that ball. You know, it was right there.
Oh, that was, I think that was our first big rally there that we saw between both schools.
Yeah.
Probably a little too many free balls there, but at the same time, nice job by the North to get that point.
Yeah.
Set here to right back by the South. Not able to control that out of system play. And the North pushing a couple points here. Number nine, Alexis Roost, still back serving. This is her third time getting her serving spot. Serve down line. Got a D attack coming here by the South attack, by the South schools. Annie Pecanino bump setting. Free ball over to the South. South responding with a middle attack. Big block there by Bella Cormick from Escalon.
It's a great block.
You know, Escalon, section title winning school, and Bella Cormick a big part of that.
Yep.
15-6 here, North leading. Serve to middle back, out of system play to the outside. High touch, not able to get that tip over. If you're the South School's head coach, what are you thinking right now?
I would definitely probably do a timeout.
Right.
They just need something different, you know.
Roos with the serve, down line, getting her target to move and getting another ace.
I'm waiting for the timeout. Oh, we got a sub.
Got substitution here, number 11, Abigail Glenn. I believe, finding her first the court for the first time. Roost with the serve. Again down line. South still struggling with that serve. Outside attack coming, standing down ball. And we got McKinley King, lefty. Big attack, but blocked there by a wall of green.
That was great for the South. They definitely needed that. They were down 10 points right now, so they definitely needed that to get the momentum going.
Right, just kind of a low contact into the block there. Nice job by the South.
Yep.
South serving to middle back. Got McKinley King with the attack again to middle back. Able to be controlled by the South. Outside attack. Wow. A lot of middle back attacks here.
Yeah, they are.
McKinley King with her third attack in the row. Hits it long.
If I was the coach for the South, I'd be like, go to corners now. It's not working. Never works.
Score is 8-17. North still leading, but the South finding some good momentum. South with the serve. Straight to middle back. Able to be controlled. Right side attack here.
Atena.
Oh, clip the pin.
Yep.
Clip the pin, and those pins serve as out-of-bound markers. When they're touched by the ball, it's going to be out of bounds.
Yep.
Number 11, Abigail Glenn, back to serve. Or actually, Jenna Gomes, back to serve. Middle attack here by Bella Cormick. Big swing. Even though she was able to get a piece of the ball there, out of bounds, back over the net. Nice swing.
The hitters for the North are doing a really good job with hitting the corners, and that's where the South is kind of struggling because they're hitting right to their middle back.
Right. And, you know, I think as coaches, you want to tell your outside and your pins to avoid that middle back position because there's somebody always waiting
right
for the ball.
They're there. Make them work.
And here, I think after a three-point run by the South, we got the North serving again, 18-9, North leading. Standing serve to middle back. Ooh, the South running a little bit of a creative play there with an A attack out the middle. Number 13, Sophia Alamo, hits it long.
Definitely want to see that again.
Yeah, I love creative volleyball play.
Especially with a team that, you know, hasn't practiced together. They
right
don't have that chemistry.
Wow.
It's very sweet.
Big attack there by, let's see, South. Who was that? Is that Emma
Number one?
Emma Blake from Turlock Christian.
You know, as being a libero, I saw Bella kind of go in the corner.
Right.
Her approach was directly kind of in that sharp angle. One more step, she would have got that.
Yeah. Actually, that was Felicity Still from Houston.
Oh, was it?
Attack.
Okay.
And now we got number 11, Cora Cover from the North, able to get that tempo attack down the middle. Big kill.
Really cool to see the North, you know, cheer as if they play together forever.
Some of
that
them
was
have
cool. I know. I love it.
Some more substitutions here. Kate Cover coming back in for number 6, Lydell Springer.
Bella Chapman does a good job with bringing energy and a lot of talking out there.
That's good.
As a libero, that's really important.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's your position.
Yep.
North up 10 points, 20-10. Kate Cover with the serve to middle back, able to be controlled. Got a middle attack coming from the South, able to be blocked by number 11, Cora Cover, doing a little bit of everything right now.
Yep.
2 points in a row scored by her, one off the kill, one off the block.
That's great.
Kate Cover back to serve, second time, down line, nope, to middle back. South in system, big swing by number 12, Sierra Thibodeau. North sent it back, free ball over. South working hard, blocked but able to be covered. Nice job. South attacking with a down ball to middle back. Kate Cover scrambling for that set. Sets one of her best friends, Amanda Murphy, still not able to find, and we got a nice rally going on right here. McKinley King with a touch over the net. South setting their middle. Ball still in play. Amanda Murphy, not able to control the out-of-system set by the libero and hits it outside the antenna, point for the South. That was probably the longest rally that we've seen all day.
Definitely getting their mojo going.
Number 6, Addie Garst with the serve. Tough pass, tight to the net. North still able to get it over. Attack from the right side by the South. Out-of-system set by the libero for the North. Ball still alive. Got another good rally going on right now. Outside attack, able to be controlled. Kate Cover setting Amanda Murphy. Tip controlled by number 13 from Hilmar. Big attack by McKinley King. Still not able to find the floor. Attack by the South from the outside. Not able to get it through the block into the net. Point for the North.
Having King as a lefty outside, I think, is something really cool that you don't see often.
Right.
And as Bella was, you know, setting that out-of-system ball, I thought it was great. You know, there's probably some communication like, hey, push me out, you know. She's doing a really good job out there.
Right. It's weird to see a lefty on the outside instead of the right side. North up by 11 points. South really trying to find some something that works for them. Hits into the net for the second time in a row. That's number 9, Caitlin Cole, being subbed out by number 5, Hannah Bibbins from Waterford. Hofstra with the serve. Out of system play. Pipe attack by the South. Hits it long. Point North. We now have set point for the North schools, up by 13. Let's see if they can put it away.
Oh.
Service out of bounds.
No, you can't do that on game point.
They got a little bit of an emotional reaction from you.
Yeah, I was like, ugh.
What do you want to do on game point there?
Definitely just get the ball over at this point, you know. Let them make the mistake.
Right, your team's in control.
Yep.
Let's let them work for it. Kate Cover with the set. Number 11 from Hilmar. Jenna Gomes with the attack.
South's not giving up.
Nope. And South able to find another point. Touch over the net, out of bounds by the North. And South not going away quietly here at the end. 24-13, but the South has a little bit of momentum. Service to right back. Kate Cover with the bump set to the outside. And the North finally able to put away. Big kill there by Alexis Roost. Able to get that ball between the blockers and the net. North wins the first set, 25-13. You know, I would say that just from the very beginning of that set, the North controlled
the entire game,
the entire match, the pace of play.
Mm-hmm.
We did see some bright spots there from the South with some tempo play from the Hilmar players and running the outside.
Right.
I like the creativity that we're seeing from the South, but right now it's hard to it's hard to see them struggling so much. Just want to say here, just thank our sponsors. Thank our sponsor, Denair Lumber Company. Let's build together. And Stanislaus District Volleyball All-Star Game. Again, small school game going on right now between set one and set two. You have two schools here with experienced seniors, some of them playing over 8 years worth of volleyball. They've probably seen each other not only in the high school but also in the club scene.
Right.
You know, between sets right here, what do you think Michelle Springmeyer, the North head coach, is telling her girls?
You know, she's probably saying, great job, obviously. You know, it's kind of a big gap with the scores. And as I'm looking at both teams right now, I see the North literally doing some, like, you know, fun pregame, you know, dance, and they're hugging. And you see the South, and they're kind of just standing around, not – you know, don't know each other as much, so you can definitely see the connection with the North. But definitely the South may come back and, you know, fix what they needed to. A lot of communication errors.
Right. I would say this, you know, never doubt Ken Shaw and what he can do with his squad, especially a squad full of experienced seniors. But again, just kind of looking at the body language between both schools right now, you have the North a little bit looser, having fun, connecting with each other. The South just kind of quiet, you know, trying to get some direction here from their coaching staff. Trying to figure out a strategy. You know, one thing that we talk about, that volleyball coaches like to talk about, is the serve and pass battle.
Mm-hmm.
And here, obviously, with the score there at the end of the first set, the North winning that serve and pass battle, how important is that in each game?
It's so important. I think serving wins games, but obviously serve receive is, those two are just the main thing. And I think the North did a really good job with, you know, taking advantage of it and, you know, getting on runs. And I think the South now realizes that. And so they're going to correct things, definitely their serve receive passes, and come out make it more competitive.
Right. You know, if there's anything that worked for that South side or for the South school, it's the middle attack. Number 12, Sierra Thibodeau, finding some early success, and even there at the end competing, still competing with the North, wanting the ball in her hands. And, you know, I thought that she could be somebody that could be a difference maker here in the second set.
Definitely. Coach is probably telling them, hit corners. Definitely somebody who's saying them.
Right now, a lot of things happening right now with the outside attacks going to middle back. Some stats here for you. For the North School, we have number 23, Bella Cormick, with 4 kills. Kate Cover and Emily Van Groningen with 2 blocks. For the South, Felicity Still with 2 kills. Leilani Aguilera with 4 digs, and Jenna Gomes and Sophie Alamo with 1 block apiece.
With a game like this, I feel like stats are all, like, all around. You know, you don't have, like, the setter's setting everywhere. They don't have that, like, solid outlet, really, you know, because they haven't played together, so you don't have, like, a go-to, like, hitter at this point. So you can see the stats are kind of all over the place with the hitters. That's good to see, though.
And that's one part, you know, we haven't really talked much about Addie Garst here from Hillmar, the setter for the South School. Really working hard to keep those first passes in system for her hitters. I think she's done a great job bettering the ball for her for hitters and giving her South team an opportunity to score.
Most definitely.
Here we go, beginning of the second set. South with the serve. Addie Garst serving to right back. Kate Cover with the bump set to the outside to Manny Murphy. Big swing by Manny Murphy. Big kill on the outside. Again, the North showing a ton of energy.
Ton of energy. I love to see it. That's like my favorite part about volleyball. The love for the game, the excitement.
Well, you got the North starting in rotation 6. Kate Cover back to serve. Good server with a nice jump float. South struggling with the pass. Free ball back over. North sensing an opportunity with a big attack out the middle. And that's number 23, Bella Cormick, again putting that ball away. Bella from Escalon, again, section champion, and even went to the state tournament.
The South, again, needs to take care of that right back.
Kate serving again, this time to number 4. Abby with the back set. And we have a net violation here. Looks like there was some confusion there with the South School.
Right.
Score is 3-0. All momentum right now on the North side. Let's see what the South can do to get this side out. Kate back to serve. Kate.
Ace. With the ace. Kate with the ace.
Kate with the ace. It rhymes, right? Kate always being a good has always been a good server her entire career. Her first volleyball pitcher is of her serving. So Kate again back to serve. Putting a little heat on it to the outside. North able to get an out-system attack. Back set to McKinley King. McKinley King able to find the floor for the first time. Big kill there on the right side.
See, now that seems normal. Her hitting on the right side definitely seems normal. She's a great hitter.
It's 5-0 for the North. Kate back to serve. Kate still going to middle back. Abby with the back set. To her teammate.
Right up.
Nice
by number 18
dig.
On the North.
Talk about defense right there. Number 18, Addison Machado. Just
all smiles. Her team was hyping her up.
As somebody that plays left back, does that play impress
you?
Oh,
I love that. Those are my favorite. The ones I have to go get and I'm on the floor, those are my favorite.
Wow, 6-0 North after a big play. Still back set from the South. Not able to get a swing. Kay Covert set to the outside of Manny Murphy, blocked by the South. North able to cover, got a free ball back over, struggling with that first pass, and North still has the momentum up 7-0 here early in the second set.
The group we have right here, the 6 on the North, is just, they're so fluid. They know where each other are going already, and it's only the second set.
Right. If they were a high school team, they'd probably find a lot of success.
Oh, yeah.
South attacking from the outside, not able to get it down line past the net.
I was just going to say, that's what's fun about this, because it's all like the all-stars of each school, so it's cool to see.
The South with a substitution here. Number 5, Hannah Bibbins, being substituted by number 6, I believe, Esmeralda Arroyo from Watford. Kate Cover serving for the 7th time or 8th time. South still out of system. Middle attack. Kate able to defend. McKinley King with the attack from the right side. Nice deep attack. Able to find the floor. Wow. What can you say? North has all the momentum right now.
All the momentum. And as a hitter, you know, she's going to keep hitting a spot that keeps being open, and smart of a hitter. King's doing a really good job.
Kate Cover back to serve. 9-0. North leading. Kate with another ace. Wow. What can you say?
We were just talking about how, you know, the South needs to do a better job with serve receive. You know, that's what they're struggling right now. Even their libero, you know, she needs to kind of step up and take control out there.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought, personally, I thought there was going to be like...
Amanda Murphy here with 3 kills, total now, and McKinley King with 3 kills. Here in the second set, North finding a lot of momentum early, up 10-0. Kate Cover back with the serve to middle back. South still struggling. Free ball back over. Kate Cover with the set to their middle. Able to be dug. South responding with an outside attack. Not able to get it through McKinley King or Bella Cormick. Nice block by the North. North up 11-0. South still trying to find their first point here. Kate serving tough, and nobody going after that ball. Looks like the South is just on their heels right now. What would you be telling them?
Communication. Someone needs to go for the ball. Someone needs to be out there who wants to go to the ball too. A lot of staring. We got a sub here.
I got a substitution. Looks like number 5, Hannah Bibbins, going back in on the outside. Hannah Bibbins, the Waterford High School outside. Kate Cover with the serve. And Kate Cover shows that she is human.
Yep.
And with her 13th serve attempt in the second set, serves it out of bounds. First point here for the South. They got Jenna Gomes serving from Hilmar.
It's a good run.
Oh, we got a substitution as well. Number 5, Hannah Bibbins, looks like she's going back in. Gomes with the serve to middle back, able to be controlled by the North. Manny Murphy just doing what she does best, with just killing the ball off of her favorite setter. Assumed favorite setter, Kate Cover.
Yeah, I mean, I just can't get over the connection that these girls have. I mean, it makes sense. You know, a lot of them have played together in club. It's cool to watch.
You know, and timing issue is not even an issue here for those two. Grace Ferreira with the serve. South in system, able to get a swing, but not able to find the floor in bounds. Hitting it just out the sideline, number 12, Sierra Thibodeau.
Kate Cover doing a good job reading the court. You know, she was down and ready, knew it was going to be out.
Scores 14-1, North leading. Serve to middle back in system. Touch over by the middle attacker. McKinley King with a set play coming from the right side. Being fed perfectly there by Kate Cover. And South not able to control that attack.
She is thinking her setter right now.
What a great swing.
Yep.
Grace Ferreira with another serve to left back. Having trouble with it. And
Grace. We got a
collision out there. Yeah. I'll say this. You love to see the hustle from the South.
Yeah, that was actually really good. You know, run down.
Ooh, just a little bit of a collision out there behind the ref stand. Looks like both girls are okay. Grace with the serve. South still having some issues. Abby running free ball, running for that set. Free ball over by the South. Outside attack by the North. Again, finding the court. Alexis Roost with the kill. I think that's probably her 5th or 6th kill.
Yeah, she's coming up with a lot of numbers.
She was able to hit that nice hard cross-court attack able to beat the libero for the South, Leilani Aguilera. South in system here, coming back, outside attack, big swing, able to cover herself. And nobody on the north.
That was confusing what happened there.
Well, it was, she got a nice swing on the ball.
Yeah.
She covered her own attack, which is, you know, something you'd love to see from an outside.
Right.
And ball finding its way over on the overpass.
Everyone kind of was like, oh, wasn't expecting that to happen.
I don't think the north was expecting that to happen at
no.
all. All right, we got Sierra Thibodeau with the serve here to middle back. North out of system this time. Still able to get a swing. Abby with the set to the outside. Big swing by the South, able to be controlled by the North. Outside attack by the North.
Mm.
To middle back, Sierra Thibodeau, not able to control that attack. And the North finds itself up 18-2 here in the second set. Kate Cover doing a little bit of everything, getting those balls high and hittable on those out-of-system sets. And the North just doing what they do best, which is getting those big kills.
Yeah, Kate's doing a good job being a glue to this team for the North.
Bella Cormick here with the serve. South out of system. Abigail with a bump set to the right side. Touch attack over. And Emily Van Groningen. That's not something you see very often with the attack out of bounds, just out the sideline. Feed from Kate Cover there. Two people that have worked together for probably the last 5 or 6 years.
Right.
Playing some elite volleyball. That time, not able to connect. Got the serve from the South to right back. Kate Cover with the back set to McKinley King. McKinley King hitting it long, trying to hit that hard angle shot, just not there.
I like how the North is trying to move the ball around and not keep hitting to the same spots. Even though it's working, they're kind of just like moving things around. You know, it's okay to make errors, just got to change them fast.
And the South looks like there was a bad toss there on the serve, trying to force the issue, and got the service error there by the South.
Yeah, the South really needed to keep the ball to get the momentum going for their team.
Well, here in the second set, the North up 19-4. Again, like North just controlling the pace, controlling everything that's going on right now. Annie Pacanino subbing in to serve, number 26 from Central Catholic. Somebody that's, you know, as somebody that's worked with Annie, Annie's got a great attitude and is just a fantastic volleyball player. South with a set to the outside, big swing, big kill. Nice job by the South there to get a swing on that ball and just challenging the North. Looks like she almost six-packed that left back, the libero there by the North. Nice kill, and again, getting some energy on the South side.
That's great. They definitely needed that.
And we got a serve here by the South. Middle attack by the North, and Emily Van Groningen putting it away, cutting that shot back to the right side.
The back row is doing a really good job with moving their feet. All of them moving their feet, and that's cool to see at this level of play.
You love to see Annie Pacanino able to set that middle attack with an out-of-system first pass.
Yeah, it's great.
It just shows the technical ability here of the North.
Definitely.
North calling a timeout here.
Surprised the North is calling it.
There might be some rotation issues.
Oh, okay, yeah, because they seem a little confused. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna go to a break here, and we'll be back.
My favorite part was just competing and meeting new people. You know, I'm always with my team, like practicing in high school. So it was good to come out and meet new people and play against them and get like, and meet some college coaches.
So, yeah. And the dribbling with the Sacramento Kings coach, that was really fun.
Meeting new people, making new friends.
Other games, I love playing games, yeah.
Just to be able to practice on my moves.
Well, my favorite part of camp is meeting new people. I've made a lot of friends so far. It's a real great experience here.
A bit too powerful. Okay. 1 second. Has another shot. Puts it up to end the game. Nails the three.
The crowd goes.
And the North still control. We're back, and the North still controlling this match. Up 15 or 20-5. Up by 15. Again, the Denaire Lumber Company being the sponsor for this All-Star game. Can't thank them enough. And NorCal Sports TV for their hard work into making this happen. The North up 15 points here in the second set, game to five right now, here with the first serve, and able to be controlled by the South to a middle attack. Number 11, looks like Abigail Glenn with that attack, and North responding with a big kill from the right side by number six, Lydell Springer. Up 21-5 right now, Chelsea.
Wow. They just need to finish it here now. The North just looks like they're having so much fun. It makes me want to get out there.
And the North, maybe we shouldn't say those things because we say it, North has a service error that time into the net.
I apologize. That's my bad.
And number four, Leilani Aguilera from Gustine.
We need a run here for the South.
You know, even though you're down this 15 points, you're still looking for some positives on your side.
Definitely.
Nice serve here.
She has a great serve.
Leilani. In system, though, is the North. Big dig there by Leilani right after her serve.
Right.
Attack to middle back. Annie Pecanino with the push.
A lot of looking there instead of just going.
And such a smart play here. Annie Pecanino, a little late to the transition to the net, but able to use her hands to attack it where no defender was waiting for that ball.
The hitters for the North are really seeing the court and putting that ball away.
Right. Addison Machado back in to serve. And if you remember, Addison had that incredible play in the first set.
Oh.
Well, was it the first set or was it the second
right,
set?
Right, they kind of all going together here.
But that big sprawling dig just laying out for that ball.
Yeah.
That just bettered that ball for her setter, Kate Cover, with a nice right side attack kill by McKinley King. All right, Abigail with the serve here. South responding with an outside attack from Sierra.
Great dig.
Abigail doing what Addison. She does best. South here with the middle attack from Sierra. Annie Pecanino playing some defense. Set to the outside to Manny Murphy, big swing. But Leilani able to get that dig. North still gets the point off of the missed attack there by Sierra. 23-6 here in the second set. North fully in control. We have Addison back to serve to middle back. Abby runs for that second ball, outside attack, long by Sierra. And again, the North finds itself 24-6 here for set point.
Set point. North's doing a good job with knowing the court.
Yeah. And Addison Machado back to serve to right back to Leilani. Middle attack response here by the middle from Hilmar.
Over.
Ooh, I think a missed call there by the official.
Yeah.
Two touches.
Yeah.
Regardless, both schools still playing. Annie Pecanino with a sprawling dig. Got a right side attack free ball over by the North. Abby setting her teammate on the outside.
Yep.
Able to get a nice kill from number 11, Jenna Gomes.
Addison, the libero, left back right now. She definitely thought that was going out.
Right.
Realized it last second, but it was too late for that.
Right.
To guess.
You know, two fantastic players there from Hilmar able to connect and get the kill.
Yeah, they needed that. That was sweet.
North with the right side attack. This time free-balling it over. Leilani with a nice dig. Outside attack by number 11, Jenna Gomes. Ooh, response there by the North. Outside attack by Amanda Murphy able to get the kill for the set point. If you look there, nice bump set. The South just touching that ball before going outside, but you love to see the hustle to get that play on the ball.
The and North really came out today.
Yep, North up here, two sets to none, winning the second set 25-7. We're going to go to a break, and we'll see you at the beginning of the third set.
Awesome.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people. Because I thought there's going to be like very little people here from all around here. But there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just got to meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was really fun.
And we're back to the Stanislaus District Volleyball Small School All-Star Game. Third annual All-Star Game, and the North fully in control here, up 2-0 over the South. And the North just kind of doing whatever it wants to do to the South. unable to respond in a way that challenges the North's experience and abilities right now.
You can tell just how much fun they're having, and you know that's the whole reason why we're here today, is just play the game of volleyball, compete, and have fun. I really want to see the South bring it this set. You know, last time they're going to play volleyball for most of the girls over there, so see some more competitiveness.
Right. As a coach, you know, I think I would be telling the South players, hey, you know, some of us might not be playing volleyball at the next level next year, so this possibly being your last set of volleyball with the uniform on, let's go out there and just leave it all on the court.
Exactly. I would say the same exact thing.
Right. And, you know, and just, again, looking at the body language here between the North and the South, the North had a lot of smiles in the huddle.
Yeah.
Being
hugging
coachable.
Each other.
Yeah. Arms around each other. You look at the South just kind of on their own in their little groups. But, you know, Ken Shaw is a fantastic coach. Hopefully he can get his girls together here on the same page. We saw some nice defensive plays there by South libero Leilani from Gustine. You know, she's showing that she's here to compete. And she's not going to just let this game go by the North. But again, North maybe just having a little bit too much talent.
Yeah.
Able to go on that. I believe it was a 12-0 run there at the very beginning of the game.
Yep, Kate Cover, the Kate aces.
Right, serving tough, doing what she does best. North here, we got some stats. Annie Pecanino in the last set having one kill. Lydell Springer having one kill. And Addison Machado with three digs. And we got our dig stats here that you were looking for.
Yeah,
we
I was
got
looking
Leilani
for that.
Aguilera with three.
Three, yeah. You know, it's good to see the South still smiling out there, and they don't look defeated. They don't look like, you know, they're down two, but we'll see what they do now.
Right. And again, volleyball is just a sport of momentum. You know, it's just really big for schools and teams. To understand that they can play with whoever's on the other side of the net. And you just sometimes need that one attack, that one kill, that one serve, that one energy play to show that you're in it.
Right. The North is doing a good job with limiting their errors, too, and that's helping them a lot with their momentum, like you were just saying.
And here we are, beginning of the third set. Familiar face, Kate Cover on the service line from Central Catholic. Here serving down line. South out of system and getting a free ball back over. North hustling for that ball. Big swing there by McKinley King. Another kill by the North.
The North does a really good job with starting off strong. They have not let it drop.
Nice back set there by Kate Cover to McKinley King. Strong connection forming between those two. Kate, again, serving tough. And Kate with another ace against South School. That time, nice jump float. Serves down or to the 5-6 seam and not able to keep that ball in the court.
Yeah, the South just needs to read it a little bit earlier.
North up 2-0. Kate Cover back with a serve down line. Abby with the set to the outside. Big swing. Still able to be controlled by the North. Amanda Murphy got a cannon on her, but the South able to control. Good defensive play there by Addison.
Mm-hmm.
North unable to get a swing on that ball. And we got a rally going on here nice and early. Number 11, Cora Grover with the attack. Trying to sprawl after that ball. And McKinley King got caught under the net over that center line violation. Both teams hustling here early in this third set. North up 2-1 here over the South. Got number 6. Addie Garst here with the serve. North in system. Backs up to Amanda Murphy with the big kill down line.
Oh my gosh. Perfect serve receive pass. Perfect set. Perfect swing.
Just what you would expect from
North.
From the North.
Yeah,
offensive player of the year for
right.
her league.
I wouldn't expect anything less.
No section champion there, Amanda Murphy, getting a kill down line. Nice job. North up 3-1 here in the third. Standing float over to Leilani. South responding with a left-handed attack there on the outside. Cora Grover with the attack, blocked by the South. And the South with another block, and McKinley King forced to free ball the ball over. Outside attack by the South. Timing issues there. But the North able to control it. Tip by number 11, Cora Grover, getting another kill in this third set. Nice touch there by Kate Cover to set up her middle for some success. And here we go. It is 4-1, North leading. Middle attack by the South. McKinley King getting the set from Kate Cover. Straight to middle back. South able to keep the ball alive. Tip attack over. Overpass by the North. Abby with a back set to number 5 on the South side school. Abby with a huge defensive play there, sticking her hand out. And Kate
faked it.
Kate doing her best impressionation of a Nanny Pecanino, able to dump that ball over. But it's good to see some defensive effort there by the South. But Kate Cover finding the floor.
It's a good rally, too.
Yeah, absolutely. 5-1 North leading. The South schools there. Number 1, Felicity, still not able to get that attack over the net from Abby. Abby Karst.
It comes down to errors for the South.
Right. And
there we go.
No error on that play.
Nope.
And you have a fantastic attack there by the South. Abby Garst able to set up number 5, Carissa Hoekstra from Stone Ridge Christian. Hoekstra with the serve. North in system, set to McKinley King.
I want to say that's her first error. Hitting error?
I think it's her first hitting error. Those in their first set, she wasn't able to put away that time, hitting it long. But North finding itself challenged by the South.
Yeah.
Service error here by the South gives a point back to the North. North schools up 7-3 here in the third set. And we got libero Bella Chapman coming in to serve. And Bella Cormack coming in to play middle for the North. Bella Chapman with the serve. Little lollipop over to left back. Abby with the back set. South with a touch attack over.
Straight up by
wow.
Bella.
Big swing there, but the South able to defend with their own swing. And we got a big rally coming here from both. Neither team wanting to lose this point. Big swing by the South School, but blocked. Blocked there by McKinley King and
energy.
Bella Cormack.
Wow. Bella really brings a lot of energy. I really enjoy watching her. As I watch her, you know, body language, she's ready for anything coming her way.
Neither side wanted to lose that point.
No.
But going the North's way, 8-3 North.
Great swing by the South.
South able to show that. They can stay with the North here in this third set. Felicity Sill with a nice attack to the 1-6 seam. Nobody in the area.
She does a good job reading the court.
South with a standing serve. And the South getting their own ace.
Good.
That's kind of an unusual serve there, but it worked. Ball just died once it crossed the net. Nice ace by the South.
Kind of a fast serve.
Yeah. McKinley King with the push attack.
Great spot, King.
Ooh. Again, you know, just kind of placing that ball out of system set or out of system play and able to get a high contact on that ball. Way to push it down line for the point.
King's a smart player. You can tell. She's really seeing the court over there.
She is. But sometimes when you hit that ball out of bounds, that next one's going to be a little bit more off speed.
Yes.
Ace here by the North Schools. Annie Pecanino able to find the floor. What a great float. If you watch the serve here, you see that ball, again, just die once it crosses the net.
Mm-hmm.
Annie Pecanino with her second serve in the third set. South able to control, outside attack. But the wall of Kate Cover and Bella Cormack will not allow.
Nothing's getting past them today.
You shall not pass right
you
here.
You shall not pass.
You got the outside attack here by number 13, Sophia Alamo, and blocked by the North. Back set here by the South, able to be controlled by the North. Annie scrambling for that ball. Oop. A little miscommunication error there by the North.
Yeah, that happens. Setters and liberos, they're both out there wanting to make plays.
Right. And again, you'd like to see two people hustling for that ball instead of none, right?
Exactly.
North able to get that point. Annie Pecanino back for her third serve. Leilani with the reception and a pushover by the South. Annie with a right side set to Kate Cover, and Kate Cover gets her, I believe, second kill of the game.
She went for those hands, and it worked.
Right. Again, great job here by Kate Comer, working hard off the net, transitioning without playing that ball and able to get a kill. Abby with a set to her middle. And that set play out of the serve receive, not able to cross the net. And the North finds itself up 14-5 here in the third set. Annie Pecanino back to serve. South able to control. Big swing. Hey, nice scrambling defense there by the North. And, oh, you hate to see that. Communication error there between the two hitters on the South. Not a bad set. Good hands there, but just nobody wanting to get that ball.
Right.
North finding itself up here 10 points in the third set, 15-5. Nice attack there by the South. Kate Cover.
Great swing, deep line.
Can you say that that Kate Cover is just totally multi-talented, can swing,
she
can set, can dig, can serve. Fantastic setup by her teammate there, Annie Pecanino. Nice kill.
Great job.
Annie with a nice float. South able to control.
Great up.
Number 13, Sophia Alamo with a big swing. Nice cover.
Coverage on the North.
Another swing by the North.
So it seems that the North obviously has a lot of momentum. I think the South just needs to slow down the game a little bit. You know, they're just letting them have the momentum, you know. Someone needs a Tyler Shue or something.
Get the ball high and hittable. Alexis Ruth able to find the kill there on the last point. North up 17-5.
Great.
Little push ball.
Little might have hit her head. She's okay, though. She's strong.
A little push ball there by Hoekstra over the block, and everybody just watching except for left back. Hoekstra back to serve.
She's just a little bit deep.
And a no-go there again. Second no-go in a row there by the North, and Michelle Springmeier gets to her feet, making some substitutions, seeing some things that she didn't like.
Yeah.
You got Emily Van Groningen back in. Huge offensive threat. Here we go. North in system for the outside attack. Alexis Ruth tipping over the block. Free ball back over. Watch for an attack here by Emily Van Groningen. Wow, big dig.
Great
there
dig
by the South.
Her.
Annie Pecanino setting her outside.
Great spots.
Right, and Alexis Ruth able to find the floor there in zone six. Overpass there by the South just provided a nice opportunity for the North to respond with some tempo.
Yep.
North finds itself up 18-7 here in the third set. And again, just as the first two sets, completely in control.
They are here to win, that's for sure. Timeout.
And as we take this timeout, we'll take the timeout as well, and we'll be back.
My favorite part was just competing and meeting new people. You know, I'm always with my team, like practicing in high school. So it was good to come out and meet new people and play against them and get like, and meet some college coaches.
And the dribbling with the Sacramento Kings coach, that was really fun.
Meeting new people, about making new friends.
Other games, I love playing games, yeah.
Just to be able to practice on my moves.
My favorite part of camp is meeting new people. I've made a lot of friends so far. It's a really great experience here.
Bit too powerful. 1 second. Has another shot. Puts it up to end the game. Nails the three.
The crowd
Here is Shiner
wild.
For three. Yes, look at this. Everyone coming over to congratulate.
Literally ball in the air as the buzzer went off.
Do you have
Beautiful
the chills?
Finish.
I have the chills.
I definitely
look
got
at that.
The chills.
And we're back. And again, we'd like to thank the Denaire Lumber Company for sponsoring this event. Let's build together. Alexis Roos, number 9 for the North, with the serve after the timeout.
Ace.
Wow. You don't get off
the bat.
She has not been beat often this game. That time on her heels. When you do that overhand dig, you want to be stronger than the serve, and that time not able to.
Right. Also move her feet a little faster again.
Ooh. And we're seeing the North finding some success here on the service line. Leilani struggling middle back right now with that first touch. Let's see if she can fix it.
Seems to be in her head a little bit.
Right, number 9, Caitlin Cole with that first pass. Free ball over by the South. Tip here by Amanda Murphy. South able to control. Number one, Felicity Sill attacking from the outside, hitting it long, point for the North. Up 21-7 here in the third set. Alexis Roos back to serve. Nice hard serve down line. Abby with the set to middle. North still able to control even the best shot from the South.
Right.
Unfortunately, Liddell Springmeyer, or Liddell Springmeyer, not Springer, not able to control that attack and hit it right into the middle of the net. South with the point. And we have Felicity Sill with the serve. Nice tough serve out of system by the North.
Good touch.
Nice. Holy smokes. Stick your arm out and maybe some good things will happen.
It's rare, but it happens.
Right. Leilani with a nice dig. Ooh.
She had that.
Right. South, unfortunately, there with an attack error hitting the pin. North finding itself up 22-8 here in the third set. I would say that was more of a timing issue, you know.
Yeah,
let the ball get by you.
Yeah, I thought she let the ball pass before. You know, she definitely could have been one more step ahead. But she did ask her setter. I saw her, okay, can you push it in a little bit?
Right.
That happens.
It does. Looks like we have Addison Machado and Bella Cormick back in for the North. Addison again with that great defensive play early on in the game with a tough serve here to Felicity Still. South with a down ball in response. Andy Pecanino with the back set. And the North hitting it long. Number six, Liddell Springer. Not able to find the court on that attack. Nice back set there, you know, again sharing the ball amongst everybody on the court. North fully in control, up 22-9 here in the third set. South able to serve. Leilani with her jump serve. North able to control. Out of system. Tip here by the North. Back set by the middle from South Schools. Manny Murphy with the attack.
A little under her.
Yeah. Timing issue there again. Maybe she wasn't expecting expecting that set.
Yeah, it seemed like that was the issue.
Right. Late to the ball. Hit that top tape.
Yeah.
Leilani Aguilera with the serve. Struggling with that pass.
Ooh, they called carry. Yeah. It was good effort.
It was, you know, and again, it's something good to see when your setter works hard for that ball, trying to better it for the outside.
Yeah.
That time, unfortunately, ball just rested a little too long in her hands. A
little bit.
Leilani with her third serve. Still competing. North up 22-11 here. Amanda Murphy with the attack to middle back. South able to play some defense, but sends a free ball back over. And Bella Cormick.
Oh, great hustle.
Wow. Bella Cormick with a big hit. Huge hustle play there by the South. But as we've seen all all game long, North able to control it. Look at that swing by Bella Cormick. Great up there by Leilani Aguilera. And good hustle play there by the South to keep that ball alive, give them another opportunity. But Amanda Murphy, Offensive Player of the Year, just hammering that ball down, making sure the North stays in control. North up 23-11 here in the third set. Kate back to serve.
That rally was just great volleyball all around.
It was. It was. And we got three people going after that ball. Nice little touch there. Just over the double block.
Yeah.
Three people hustling after it. You love to see that hustle, but great point there by the South.
I was just about to say that, too. At least you're having three instead of none. Like, South kind of struggled with that. You know,
right.
There's a lot of no-goes, but at least we're having North, you know, all commit to it. So.
Right. Now we have here set point by the North off the Avigar serve. You see Kate Cover there finding her middle, Bella Cormick, for the tempo attack. A nice one kill. And this is match point
match
here by the North.
Match point.
And we got standing float to middle back. Leilani with a nice pass. South with a right side attack. Kate able to get that dig. Addison with the bump set to the outside. And the South not going away quietly there. Jenna Gomes finding that push attack down the right side.
South still wanting to be here. They're fighting right now.
You know, great job there by Jenna selling that hard attack and then going off speed to catch the North off guard. Abby Garst here with her second serve in a row. Standing down ball to left back. Out of system play here. Kate Culver.
I mean, I said Kate King. I just put them together because they're just a duo, I guess.
And North wins here off the kill by McKinley King.
Three.
You can see here a nice pass, or actually out-of-system pass here. Kate Culver able to better that second ball and get that kill to the daughter of the director of this event.
Right.
And McKinley King, nice cross-court attack. Small schools, North wins. Michelle Springwire puts a second All-Star win under her belt, and congratulations to the North for a nice match that they controlled from the start.
It was fun to watch. A lot of great energy out there.
Again, thank you to the Denair Lumber Company for sponsoring this event. Denair Lumber Company, let's build together, and also to NorCal Sports for recording this event and handling all of the media coverage. Between games here, small schools and large schools, we'll take a break, and we'll be back soon.
Many donations to put in there, just a coffee cup, a a jacket patch. Yeah, I said Leatherwoman jacket patch. I said Leatherwoman. Can I get an amen or something? Leatherwoman jacket patch. And there's a hydro sticker. A lot of things in that bag that we put together with our sponsors to get to each and every player. Really just for their enjoyment, just to take it home and cherish it.
Thank you.
All right. Your small school All-Star Event champions, the North Squad. Thank you very much. Now we have our coaches awards to give out. Our first award is our Screen and Core Award. Served in the military, you know what this means. Pride, how you take care of your family, your team, just how you structure yourself and how you carry on as a person. This individual was chosen because she was up the whole time. I mean, she was helping everyone out. She was chosen by the coaches on both sides of the court for this award. She conducted herself in a manner that was above anyone else. I mean, it was an easy decision. This is Leilani Aguilera of Bestine High School. Next award is our Defensive Player of the Game Award. And just to let you know how this happens is the game's played out and then all the coaching staff and both teams confer, they share notes, they hash it out, they make decisions, and they were unanimous, pretty much. Yeah, this Defensive Player of the Game Award goes to Bella Chamberlain of our women's.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills, and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people. Because I thought there's going to be like very little people here from all around here. But there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just got to meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there's gonna be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just gotta meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there's gonna be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just gotta meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there's gonna be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just gotta meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there's gonna be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just gotta meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people, because I thought there's gonna be like very little people here from all around here, but there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and you know, just gotta meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was fun.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
with some key players of the game. I'm Chelsea B, the host, commentator here today. I'm with Kate Cover. I have Bella Chapman. I have Addison Machado, and I have McKinley King. These are the key players of the game. They did a really good job. You guys had a lot of good chemistry out there, and it's so weird because you guys haven't played together, a lot of you guys, obviously. So how did you guys, you know, get that chemistry out there? Who wants to speak on that?
I mean, for me personally, I've played with a lot of these girls. I've known them since, like, I've played with Alexis since sixth grade. I've played with a lot of these girls on club team. Like, we used to, like, play on 14s, and then a bunch of these girls I go to school with, and we're all just friends. So what really wasn't hard, like, the first practice, we were all friends. And, like, it really just worked together. And at that first practice, we were, like, an actual team. So it's really cool.
Really good job. And a lot of energy, too. So, like, you know, as a libero, you guys, like, I'm a libero, too. And I'm, like, you know, I'm the loudest one on the court, right? So I saw that out of both you guys. Everyone. You guys all did a really good job. So how do you bring energy, you know? Were you guys excited? Were you nervous? Like, what brought that today?
I was honestly so excited for this game, and the thing that always gives me the most energy is knowing that I'm going to bring up my team by being the loudest that I possibly can and just going for everything no matter what, no matter if I think that there's a chance or not, because I know that's just going to make my teammates want to work just as hard as I do.
100%. So a lot of great defensive plays, right? All of you guys did a great job. So what do you, like, see on the other court? Like, what are you looking for, like, people who, you know, are going to be coming into high school? Like, what's something that you can give back to, you know, players coming in high school?
I think most important is just knowing your opponents and adjusting really quickly. If you get beat once, just don't get beat again.
I think it's, like, super important to be, like, super loud, and, like, Bella, like, always calls out spots for me, and it's, like, super helpful. So just, like, talking as much as you can, like, being super loud, it just helps everyone, like, all the way around, like, back row to front row and everything.
I agree 100%. And I wanted to talk to you two because you guys had a great connection, you know. As a setter, you guys obviously went to the same high school, but you had a great connection. Like, did you guys just, it just happens? Or, like, do you guys talk about it throughout the game? You know, as a lefty, you know, you had some great kills tonight. It was, you know, on the outside, too. I was talking up there. I'm like, she had lefty on the outside? I thought she played right side. You were doing both, and it was, like, really cool to see. So, like, tell me about that. Like, what's your guys' connection like?
Well, it was a little, like, getting used to a setter, like, every season's a little bit difficult in the first few weeks. And I think, like, for us, it was that way at the beginning of high school. And then, like, we just kept building off of that. And we had to kind of transition when I got put to the outside. But we just, like, kept working on it. And, like, talking is, like, the most important thing for, like, hitters is, like, hey, like, can you get this, like, a different way? And then just, like, communicating with your setters is big.
I definitely saw some great things tonight. Congratulations, all of you. I'm so proud of you. I've seen you guys play at Rage. You're new, but I'm so excited I was able to watch you today. So great job tonight. Thank you so much for doing these interviews.
Thank you.
My favorite part was just competing and meeting new people. You know, I'm always with my team, like, practicing in high school. So it was good to come out and meet new people and play against them. And get, like, and meet some college coaches.
And the dribbling with the Sacramento Kings coach, that was really fun.
Meeting new people, making new friends.
Other games, I love playing games, yeah.
Just to be able to practice on my moves.
My favorite part of camp is meeting new people. I've made a lot of friends so far. It's a really great experience here.
Bit too powerful. Okay. 1 second. Has another shot. Puts it up to end the game. Nails the three.
The crowd
Gary Shiner
wild.
For three. Yes, look at this. Everyone coming over to congratulate.
Literally, ball in the air as the buzzer went off.
Do you have
Beautiful
the chills?
Finish.
I have the chills.
I definitely
look
got
at that.
The chills.
I got the goosebumps.
I really did too.